So this is a question which was asked yesterday, so about NEVUS anemicus, and this is a very important topic also for exams INICET, FMGE or also NEET or next. So if in case you have marked the answer as option B, then your answer is absolutely right. And first thing which I want to tell you is, don't get confused by looking at this word NEVUS. Don't think that this is similar to NEVUS of OTA or NEVUS of ITO. And don't mark that NEVUS anemicus is going to be associated with hyperpigmentation. Okay, so it will, the NEVUS anemicus will present as a hypopigmented skin lesion. This is absolutely correct. And this is also called as pharmacologic NEVUS. This is also called as pharmacologic NEVUS. Why? Because actually there is going to be hypopigmented skin lesion in these patients. You can see here there is hypopigmentation, and this will be seen since birth. This hyperpigmentation of the skin will be seen since birth, and this is not due to defect in the melanin, melanocyte or melanosome. So all these components will be absolutely functioning normal, but the only problem is these patients are going to have an excessive response to the catecholamines which are present in the blood, because of which there is going to be a reduced blood supply to the skin happening due to the excessive vasoconstriction produced due to catecholamine effect on alpha receptors. Okay, so this could be a assertion reason type of question also, and basically because the defect, the hyperpigmentation of the skin is not due to the melanin or its component, so this is basically also called as pharmacological NEVUS. Pharmacological NEVUS for this simple reason, that is the some chemicals are producing this hyperpigmentation, and this is not a melanin disorder. This is very, very important point which you must all remember. And the lesions will be seen since birth, and this condition has to be differentiated from one more condition which is called as NEVUS depigmentosus, which is also referred to as NEVUS achromicus. So NEVUS achromicus or depigmentosus, both of them are same. And these two conditions are very important differentials, and you can easily differentiate these two with the simple trick, or you can say a simple general knowledge. Anemicus, wherever you see, it simply means that the skin is going to look pale. So in these patients also the skin is going to look pale, and if you try to rub the lesions, then in the case of NEVUS depigmentosus, because the blood supply is all normal, and the basic problem in NEVUS depigmentosus or achromicus is actually there is a defect in the melanosome transfer. Melanosome transfer is defective, but there is no excessive effect due to catecholamines. Okay, so because of this, when you try to rub the lesional skin, then what will happen? There is going to be excessive vasoconstriction happening. Lesion becomes red. The lesion is going to become red due to vasodilatation happening due to the activation of this blood vessels. Whereas in the case of NEVUS anemicus, because of this excessive catecholamine effect, the blood vessels will be always staying in vasoconstrictive mode. They will not dilate. So there is not going to be any increased blood seen in the NEVUS anemicus lesion. So there will not be any change in the hyperpigmented skin lesion. But you can notice one more difference, that is if we perform a diascopy, then in NEVUS anemicus we can notice that border between the lesion and the normal skin will disappear due to blanching effect of the surrounding normal skin. So I will show you how this looks like. Whereas in NEVUS depigmentosus, because there is no effect in this condition on the blood vessels, the lesional skin and the normal surrounding skin will not show any kind of change. And this you can see clearly here. Diascopy is nothing but application of the pressure with the help of a glass slide. So here you are able to see the glass slide. With this we are applying a pressure, and you can see this is a NEVUS depigmentosus. The first picture, I'll call it as a NEVUS depigmentosus, which is also called as NEVUS achromicus. So this A is achromicus. Here you can notice that this is the lesional skin, and on application of the pressure with the glass slide, you are able to notice that there is absolutely no change. No change is seen in the case of NEVUS depigmentosus. Whereas in the case of NEVUS anemicus, so this is NEVUS anemicus, you can notice that previously there used to be a lesional skin which is hyperpigmented and a surrounding normal skin, but after application of the glass slide, that is Diascopy, the outline is completely lost. Now I cannot, you know, even mark where is the lesion and where is the normal skin. So this is how you can differentiate these two conditions with the help of Diascopy, and with the help of rubbing the lesion, how the differentiation can be done, I have already told you. So in nevus anemicus, because the lesional blood vessels are excessively vasoconstricted, even after provocation by rubbing, there will not be any change, any vasodilatation, which will cause the redness, erythema of the skin in normal individuals. Like for example, nevus depigmentosus, the individual's hypopigmented lesion will become red. Okay. So I hope this explanation was helpful and you have understood the differences between nevus depigmentosus and anemicus. So please give me a thumbs up so that I will understand that this kind of explanation is helpful. And actually one of the students asked, so whenever I discuss a clinical cases, please put the picture. So that's the reason why I have put in pictures and I have tried to explain this as simply as possible. And this is tomorrow's MCQ, and if you know the answer for this question, do comment your answer. So if your answer is right, I will give your answer a heart and I will show your answer in the next video.